Yes. So, level one. I died. And I am very sad. Very, very sad about it. 209 levels down the drain. It happened. So I thought, no big deal. Just fight a wither. Do it all the time, right? I forgot to bring the right bow, though. I brought my punch bow. Where did he get me? Did you destroy everything already, you jerk? Ah, I think you did. Oh, no, there's my XP. Did you really destroy it all? Everything, my elytra wings, my pick, my armor. He doesn't even care about me. What? What's going on? Why doesn't he chase me? He knows I'm weak. Yeah, he destroyed everything. Oh, that sucks. So we could buy that. I do have a good chest plate. What we need is you. You, sir. You're the good guy, right? Oh, it's just... Oh, I thought I had silk touch on, too. Okay. We can make this work, though. 22 each, man. I kind of regret using all my emeralds to build a beacon now, because I think this is all I got left. I better get one more. Aqua Affinity. Oh, I totally dodged that. I think I jumped over it. Alright, round two. Ouch. Got my good bow this time. And that makes a world of difference. And he's down. Vengeance is mine. Ha ha. Alright guys, so I got myself re-geared here pretty good. Pretty good. For the most part, I'm all set now once again. It's kind of cool. I got to like run around the world and use some of the gizmos I don't use too often anymore. Like the armor, we got the library mechanisms with all the books and stuff. It was kind of fun. But it also took a very long time. But I'm re-geared, and the good news is we got the Nether Star. So I can do my stupid little intro I originally planned for this episode. Bears. Beats. Battle Star. Galactica. Question. What bear is best? False. It's Panda Bear. Or, I also would have accepted Alexander Keith's. But, we don't have either of those in Minecraft. We do have the polar bear, though. And I've been wanting to get one of these guys for a while. I looked for one quite a few episodes ago, and I wasn't able to find one. Turns out, you don't really want to look in the tundra or extreme hills or anything. Even though there's snow there, you got to find them in ice plains or ice spike biomes or icy mountains. But not the tundra. So, I found one guy here after flying around for a little bit. They're not super common from what I can tell. The problem with these like old worlds like I have here is if new mobs come out, it can sometimes be difficult to get them. And I only see one. Oh, there's... Wait a minute. Maybe they are more common than I thought. There's a bunch of them over here. Okay. Okay, so the next challenge is, how am I going to get these guys back? And can I breed them once I get them back? Because I would like to... Oh, he's got a cub! She's got a cub. That makes more sense. They don't get the hearts anymore when you feed them wheat. Okay. Okay. Well, I brought obsidian here to make a portal. I guess let's do that, and we'll see if we can get them through. And take them over my boat ice highway. If we can... Ah! No! I wasn't between you and your cub. The cub was right next to you. Well, they kind of leave you alone after you run away. I've, like, done nothing with these polar bears since they've come out. So I don't even know how they work, really. Oh, they get angry fast, though. Your cub is right next to you. I know, like, they get angry if you get between their cub and them. But maybe if you're just close to them when they have the cub. Okay, well, you're perfectly where I want you right now, actually. So bye-bye. And your cub is all mine. We're going to run away together. Oh, he went through. Okay. So, I'm kind of scared to go through already because I know there's a good chance I won't be able to get back through the portal. It might link up somewhere else. So we'll try this. We'll get a couple of them through here. I don't think there's any way to breed them currently in the game. I'll try fish, though. But it doesn't seem like the wheat's working. Okay, here we go. Through the portal, where is this going to take us? Are we going to get them home safely? Oh man, it took them right here. Uh-oh. I'll save you. No, I won't. You're going to die. Oh, I just punched you. Oh, you die. And they drop rails when they die. No, I broke a rail. Okay. So it actually took me right to this portal. That's great, kind of. Except they killed them. But it looks like two of them survived here. So we got the little baby in the boat already. I'm going to put down another boat, I guess, and just run them down the highway here. This should be fairly easy. I just might have to be careful about running into the wall. Might suffocate them as I go down the path here, at least with the big guy. Okay. You go in boat. He's so big. Are you going to suffocate if I brush against the wall? No, it's good. It's good. Okay, sweet. Woohoo! This does not look right. And yet, it's very awesome. Okay. Man, I'm so glad I built this ice road. Like, it's... Oh, hello. It's proven to be quite useful so far. All right. So this will get us to the nether hub, but beyond that, I'm not really sure where to take them. Okay, so we got them over here, and I went and got some fish and stuff just to try it. I don't think it's going to work, though. Oh. Oh, hey, why are you mad at me? I guess the cub is still nearby, right? Okay. That's actually very awesome. It's like dancing on command. I like it. I wonder if that changes the collision, like when they stand up, if I put a tripwire above it, if you could activate it somehow. Turn it into a proximity sensor, you know? Alright, so fish doesn't seem to be working. I brought a few different types. Like, salmon seems to be the one that should work. Like, when they were first added, wheat would give them hearts, but I don't think it actually would breed them. So, yeah, I don't think that's part of the game yet. I did think of a place where we could put them, though. So, first thing I'm going to do is... Oh, yeah, I brought leads. Oh, okay. Get some out of the boat, too. I didn't expect that. That's interesting. So, it's kind of like a... Like, they're considered a neutral mob, but they will attack you, too. If you upset them. I don't think you can lead... wolves, can you? Like the wild wolves? Now I'm kind of want to try that out. Oh, what's that? That looks like an Enderman. Picked up a piece of netherrack. Okay, can I lead both of you? Oh, you went back in the boat. Oh, now they're both in the boat. Actually, here. I'm going to fire resistance them first. I gotta try to get them through the creeper phase, which is always a challenge, especially when mobs are mad at you. I guess we'll do it one at a time. It's probably safer. Here we go. Yeah, feel free to maul me. Okay, so I gave them a fire resistance and a regen, so I should be able to pull them through here, right? Apparently, they're really good swimmers. Alright, I'm just gonna keep them in this pool here. That way we can see them. I think that'd be cool. I don't think they'll drown. Right? We'll try this out. I'm gonna go get the little baby. What did I just do? Yeah, they're pretty good swimmers. This is cool. So we got ourselves a little polar bear display in the man cave here. If we want, we can go swim with them. And occasionally she seems to get mad at me. Oh, it just grew up. The baby just grew up. Oh, snap. Oh, it was so cute before. Can we... Yes, we could fence them, too, if we wanted. so that's pretty cool. I like that. I really hope they add the breeding and stuff with the polar bears, because then you could do some cool stuff with them, I think. Or are you going to get stuck underneath those ladders? She might. I better remove those, just in case. Occasionally, they seem to like go under the water for a long time. I'm a little worried they're going to drown in this thing. But it hasn't happened yet, so I think we're okay. Trying to learn how to fly in the... What do you call this? Third-person view? Front view camera? Whatever it is. You do the fall, and then the fly, and... But anyways, guys, let's move on with our episode here today. We're going to try to do some building now. And I'm just, like, having fun figuring out how to fly in third-person view there. Getting a lot better at it now. So we're over here at the Amplified Terrain Base. I have a project in mind that I think is going to be pretty cool if we can get it to work here. I want to try to build a clock tower. Oh, not enough altitude. You know what I didn't put on this bow is unbreaking, so it's like breaking very quickly. Kind of a problem. Gonna have to stop using it here pretty soon. Oh no, I can't get up. Up into the sky, up, up, and away. All right, so I want to try to get over to there, right? Yeah, we're going to try to build a clock tower, guys, which isn't a super difficult thing to do in Minecraft, but to make a working clock tower is going to be pretty tricky, I think. It'll be a good challenge. And I want to maybe build it, like, right up on the wall, like above the tunnel here, or else maybe up over there. It's got to be somewhere we can see it, though. There's not a lot of spots, unless we're flying. We would see it a lot easier if it was up there. We'll think about it for a second here. But yeah, to build a clock in Minecraft, like not a digital clock, I'm talking an analog 12-hour clock with the hands and all that stuff, right? No minute hand, just the hour hand probably is all we're going to do. Is very difficult because let's say we set the time on this clock and then we leave the area here. The time in the game is still going to keep running, but the chunks are going to unload here. So the clock's going to stop, and then when we come back, it's going to be the wrong time, right? Or if we sleep in a bed, it's going to change the time in-game, and the clock isn't going to change. So how are we going to deal with that? I am not exactly sure. That is the challenge with this. So I was thinking about using daylight sensors for it, but it turns out they're not super good either because they mostly detect... Oh, hello. Mr. Scary Pants over here. They mostly detect, like, the sunrise and the sunset. That's when they change the most. Like, you can get a signal out of these. I'm not comfortable over here. There's a lot of... Oh, actually, I might not have a... Oh, I don't have a... Nope. We're not in the sun right now. Okay, so I decided to hop into a creative world just to show you guys this. Makes it a lot easier. The Minecraft day is divided into 24,000 ticks, so like every 1,000 is 1 hour in-game, 1 hour on the clock that we want to show here. So if we go to 23,000, that's like 11 o'clock in-game, and you can see the redstone is at 2 right now, just switched to 3. If we go ahead 1 hour in-game to 12 o'clock, goes way up, like 7 or 8, right? So it's not like every 1 hour in game moves the redstone one block. That makes it very difficult to use this for timing, the daylight sensors here. But what we're going to use these for is for resyncing the clock every day, I think. So we're going to use like a hopper timer or something to keep track of the time, because that's consistent. This isn't consistent. And then, like, if we leave the chunks or if we sleep in our bed, every day just after that, we're going to set the clock again, using something like this. If you, this is a cool trick you can do with comparators, by the way. Put a redstone torch, then a repeater, hook them together, and then another redstone torch. This allows you to detect a specific redstone distance. So this will detect the third one, wherever the redstone torch is here. So if we go to 22,000, for example, the redstone shuts off here. If we go to 24,000, though, it's going to turn it all on again. But it didn't activate the note block here. It's only if it's exactly three that it'll activate. So if we go to 23,000, it's at two right now. Jumps to three, then it activates the note block. So that's how we can detect when it's a certain time in the day, like right after we sleep. Then we're going to set the clock. And I was just playing around with the layout here. I think this is what we're going to go with. It seems like a good spacing between the hours here. So that would be 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, and so on. If you compress it smaller, it just doesn't look as good, I don't think. And this makes it pretty nice because we can draw a hand like that. We'll probably use pistons, sticky pistons, to make the hand come out too. Think that'll work out pretty good. So we're back in our world again now, and I got Unbreaking 3 on the bow. I put it on, fixed it up a little bit, and I have started on the clock. It's gonna be crazy. You see all that green? Those are pistons. I don't know if we're gonna be able to control it as well as I would like to, without having trouble with like budding and stuff, but we'll see. We will see. And yeah, we're not gonna worry too much about the looks today. We're just trying to get that working. But I would like the tower to be maybe like at least that tall and go down to like there at least. I'm gonna remove a lot of that land over there and then make a flat spot for the tower to sit on. I think would look pretty cool. And I put it out way out there so you know, you can see it from a wide range of angles, hopefully. Not just like if we're just up here looking there, you know. Should be quite doable over there. So, what I'm gonna do next, trying to figure out how to activate these pistons, probably. I don't know. Let's see, where's the center? This is gonna be nuts. I might make it where I get rid of these ones just to make it a little bit easier on myself, but we'll see. Well, I tried. I really did try here, but I can't figure it out. This is a head scratcher. I almost think it's not possible, but this is a good challenge for you guys. Maybe you can figure out a way. So I got the 12 o'clock working. You see the hand comes out like that. No problem. Where is it? There it is. Okay. Then this one. I thought I was going clockwise, but I forgot I'm on the backside here, so I'm doing counterclockwise apparently from where I started. So that's 11 o'clock. That's working good. That's doing what it's supposed to. No problem there. But then beyond that, like that really tricky thing about working with pistons is you got to be careful of budding and all that stuff. And generally, you need two blocks tall. To activate them, which doesn't work when you have the pistons all clumped together like I do here. So that's 10 o'clock, and you can see there's a piston there that's supposed to be out, and I just can't get it to work. Even to get this one to work as well as it did, I had to do like a update trick here. And yeah, beyond that, it just kind of keeps getting worse and worse. I'm running out of space here to do the wiring, so. Yeah. Not really sure what to do about this. We might just have to only light up the lamps, which kind of stinks. Aha! All right, guys. So I decided to just go ahead with it here anyways. It's not going to be quite as cool as I had originally hoped, but should be cool nonetheless. We can activate like three out of the four pistons on the arm, so we'll see what it looks like. Hopefully it's not too derpy. This might be a really derpy build. I haven't built it yet, so who knows how it's going to turn out here. But let's see here. What we got to do now. So all the arms are sort of figured out, like how to activate the pistons. And all these levers that you see are the connection points. So this would be the 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. That's where we have to connect to make the arm pop out like that and the light to turn on. So if it's 3 o'clock, for example, we want that to be on, right? But we don't want any of the other arms to be on. Which is a tricky thing, but I realize we can just do that trick we were planning on doing for syncing the time as well with this. So, this is not like the ideal place to do redstone. Kind of floating in the midair here. But yeah, basically what we're going to do is have a dropper output a signal, and then we'll do that whole redstone torch repeater trick that we did before. And then we'll know if it's exactly like 1 o'clock, exactly 2 o'clock, and so on and so forth. All right, so here we go, guys. I thought I'd show you this before I add any more onto it, because it's just going to get more and more crazy looking. But it's actually very simple. It's that trick I showed you earlier with the redstone torch and the repeater. It's just repeated many times here. So this device over here is what keeps track of what time to display on the clock. Depending on how many swords are in the dropper, changes the hand on the clock. So it's actually a fairly simple concept. So we can switch them between this dropper and this one. If we shut it all the way off here, let's go see what time it is. I think it should be 6. Something I realized while doing this, like the time 0 in Minecraft is when the sun comes up, right? But in the real world, you know, the sun doesn't come up at noon or at midnight. So I decided to shift it over 6 hours. So the sun's going to come up at 6 a.m. 7 or 8 a.m. might have been better now that I think of it. But it's at 6 a.m. That's what I did. That's what we're going to live with here. Depending on where you live in the world and what season is and all that stuff affects it, right? We're going by Harvest Moon rules here. Okay, so 6 a.m. the sun rises. You can see this wire is totally off. When one sword goes into here, this signal goes a distance of 2. That shuts off this redstone torch. So this is the one that controls the hour 6 hand. So if this wire is off, then the hour 6 is not out anymore. Then we do the trick here. So right now it's at this one, so we should be... Whoa, I fall down. Wait a minute. Getting really good at the parkour here. Yeah, so now we're on hour 7. And you can see what I'm talking about with the whole hand being a little bit derpy. Yeah, we're missing pistons extending in places, which I don't quite like, but it's better than nothing, right? We got 2 swords in there. Shifts 1 more hour on the clock. So it should be 8 o'clock now, and then 9, 10, 11, 12. I only got it up to 12 right now. I haven't done 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which is going to be the second half. We're just going to copy the same concept over there. So once this gets to 6, 7, then we start adding to that one. We'll need a device to switch it over. And then what we're going to do is every morning, right after you sleep, we're going to get all these swords to go back into this dropper. That'll set it to 6 a.m. on the clock there, basically. And then every night, we'll probably use a moonlight detector as well to sync it. So every 12 hours, we're going to resync the clock, basically. And then we're going to use a hopper timer every 1,000 game ticks to add 1 hour. All right, guys, so this episode is getting a little long already here, so I decided just to plow through this, get it done. And it's just about all done here. I'm going to run you through it here in just a second. But you can see we got the hopper timer running there. That's supposed to add an hour onto the clock every time it does a cycle. At the moment, I got it really sped up just so we can see this changing quickly. But that's supposed to run every 50 seconds of real time to add 1 hour on the clock here. The way this works, we have a reset right over here. This is kind of where I left off on it. And basically the reset gets all these swords back into this dropper here. Sends it 7 pulses or whatever. And that sets it back to 6 o'clock on our clock here. So I'm just going to flip this real quick. And we'll go take a viewing spot over here. We should be able to see it counting. Okay, so we missed 6 a.m., but it's at 7, 8, and 9. Kind of goes around the clock here. When it gets to 5, it's going to stop. And what we got to do is resync it using daylight and moonlight sensors. So that's the last part of this I haven't done yet. But yeah, it seems to work pretty good. I need to really figure out how I'm going to do this face on this clock, how to make it look good. As soon as we add some blocks over top of it, it's going to create more shadows on the clock, and it'll look a lot better than it is currently, because right now it's kind of exposed to the sunlight. So it goes to 5. And then before it goes to 6, we would resync it again. Otherwise, it's just going to shut off like that, is the plan. So to resync it is a relatively simple thing to do here. If you can get around. Oh, getting lag spikes too. It's not helping. Okay. So I'm trying to hurry here before the sun comes up. We can test this out. I got a daylight sensor set up there. What I figured out in Creative before is if I run at a distance of 7, that's right after you wake up in a bed, which is probably the best time to resync the clock. So if we ever sleep, it's going to be the right time, basically. What we got to do is just connect to over here. Just kind of put this in a random spot. I'll have to move it later. But I just want to try this. Okay. Do this. So that's going to turn on right when we sleep here. Let's go get our bed quickly. And we should be able to see the clock turn to 6, right? I believe, right? Okay. Oh. Actually, do we have time? Let's turn the clock on. Yeah, we got a little bit of time here. Let's turn the clock on again, and we'll try to resync it while it's running here, just to show you that it can be done. So I'm going to flip the lever. Can you tell I had no torches while building this whole thing? All right. Yeah, so we'll do that. We'll get it running again. Oh. And I guess let's sleep over here. So yeah, you see it's running up over there. So when we sleep in our bed, it's going to turn it back to 6 o'clock. That's what it's supposed to do, anyway. Okay, here we go. And then again, we got to do that with a moonlight sensor as well. I think that would probably be at 7 distance as well. Oh wow, it actually works like that. Okay. You can actually see it go back. That's weird. All right, so are you confused as I am? Basically, what we're doing, though, we're going to have a moonlight sensor as well to set it to 6 p.m. when it's that time. And as long as we're in this area for at least 10 minutes at the absolute longest, or if we sleep at any time, it's going to set it to the correct time on the clock again. So that way, if we leave the area and come back and the chunks unload, that's not going to be an issue. It'll fix itself, is the whole concept of this clock. So I think that's pretty cool. Pretty cool. So, just run you through it quickly. We saw most of this. Again, it looks crazy and complicated. That's just that trick we did repeated many times, and I had to connect each of those to one of the hands on the clock. So that made a lot of wiring here. That's what makes this look confusing. But from the daylight detector and the moonlight detector, whenever we want to reset it to 6 o'clock, we pull the signal from that, send it down this line here. Got a little monostable circuit there to make sure it doesn't stay on for long. I don't think that's important, actually. Then we have it kind of matters, because otherwise a clock would run for a long time here. But we have a pulse extender here to make sure at least 7 pulses get sent to the reset. Comparator clock, which sends the pulses. Those go down to here. So this is our reset line over here. This is our addition line right over here that the hopper timer is running to. So every time it goes over this, it adds to this dropper. And you can see we got a little piston mechanism here. This only goes up once all the swords are out of this dropper. So then it starts adding to this one. I had to split it into two because there's only 9 spots in the dropper inventory and there's 12 hours on a clock, right? Another way I could have done it is use ender pearls and just like detect the signal from 0 to 15 and do 0 from 12 that way. But I kind of wanted the signal to spread out further here so that I'd have space to do this trick here. But yeah, anyways, that's really all there is to it. Complicated, confusing. Yes, yes, yes. hope I made some sense there, though. And basically got the clock done here. I'm gonna have to do a couple more things in testing, and then we can build our actual tower, which will make it look cool, hopefully. Whoa, don't see that too often. So on a sad note, guys, unfortunately, polar bears are gone. I don't know what happened. Like, when I left, they were here. Like, when I went through the portal to the amplified terrain, they were here. When I came back, they were gone. So, yeah, maybe you guys can fill me in. Do they despawn? Because I don't know much about them, to be honest. And I couldn't see any drops in the water here. Like, no fish from them dying. So I'm kind of thinking they despawned somehow. But one other thing, though, I believe that this area here might be part of my spawn chunks. So possibly the area was loaded while I was at the amplified terrain base. And they could have either killed themselves or despawned that way as well, which explains it. Anyways, let's do the comment of the day and wrap up here for this episode. It says, "This series never fails to remind me how great Minecraft is. Etho is one of the most creative people I have ever seen." Yes. Yes, I'm truly amazing. No doubt about it. No. Thank you for that. The reason I picked this comment, though, just to reiterate, I don't really say this often, but one of the main goals with this series since the beginning was I tried to always come up with new ideas, to try to do things different or think outside the box. The reason for that, mainly, while I do enjoy it, of course, is to give you guys ideas too, make you think outside the box, try to extend the life of this game, make it fun for you for longer if you have more stuff to do in it. So maybe after watching this episode, you try to build a clock. Maybe you try to do it different than I did. Maybe you figure out how to do it better than I did. You know, that's always been the goal of the series and why I kind of play the game the way I do. As a side note of that, I don't really aim to finish projects as strongly as you might when you play Minecraft. It's more about introducing ideas than finishing ideas. But I do try to, just because it makes things nicer in the end of things here. Anyways, I will finish a clock tower, I'm pretty sure. Anyways, hope you enjoyed today's episode. Thank you very much for watching. Have a wonderful day. Take care. Bye-bye.